Hello, thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak to you about what we're doing at Vikanta. I'm very excited to tell you about how we're using nano diamonds to redefine what the boundaries are of imaging and medical diagnostics. A lot of the speakers today talked about what is going to exponentially change healthcare, and one of the things that comes up in that often is nanotechnology, and we are a nanomedicine company. So to give you perspective, if you were to look to the person next to you and say hello, there is a high likelihood that between the two of you, one of you will develop cancer. There's a 44% prevalence of cancer in the US today, and what is widely accepted across the entire industry is the earlier you detect, find metastases, find the earlier signs of cancer, the better it is for the prognosis of the patient, the better it is for the families, for healthcare costs, the overall system. And that's a space where Vikanta is in. We are using a nano diamond based technology, and we've also developed an imaging method that takes advantage of some of their unique properties to really push into how deep into tissue you can image with small devices that can be handheld and be used in earlier diagnostic kind of environments. So today, the way that this works is you inject a contrast agent into the patient. It hones in on your disease of interest. In our case, our earlier focus is on melanoma and cancer targets. It gives off a signal, and then you use an instrument to image and find that signal. So we are providing that entire packaged solution, not just the contrast agent or not just the instrument, but that in combination for early diagnostics. The problem with today's agents is, one, either a signal loss problem when you don't have great signal, or that the better agents aren't very biocompatible and won't translate into clinical applications. But nanodiamonds solve both of these problems. They have infinite signal stability. So you can kind of imagine them like tiny, tiny diamond dust particles with an infinite battery. As long as we excite them, they keep giving off their emissions. They're biocompatible. They are good nanomaterials to translate into clinical applications. And our skill set, in particular at Vikanta, is working on how to customize their surfaces and being able to translate them across a wide range of diseases. And we've developed, and this is the part that's really exciting to us right now, the last couple years of work has led us to a point now where we've demonstrated a 100-fold better signal than current imaging techniques that are out there. And we anticipate that we're going to add another zero to that soon. So we can image deeper into tissue using this technology. To give you an example, on your left-hand side is an image of a mouse where we're trying to do some sentinel lymph node imaging. This is a technique that's used to diagnose what stage of cancer you have, how much spread has happened. You can't see the lymph node, so you either assume that you don't have enough contrast agent there or it's not an effective imaging tool. But if you put that same mouse into our instrument, you can see the lymph node shine through like a beacon. So it gives you an idea of how powerful this technology is in just one slide. But if you compare it to the competition, to the other imaging agents that are out there in the fluorescence imaging space, quantum dots and organic dyes, there are a number of technical specs that the diamonds do well in. But to just translate it into what is important, the key points to take home from it, one, they resist the signal problems. Two, we can translate them into clinical applications. They won't be just a lab tool. Three, we can get deeper imaging. And four, because they are a nanoparticle, you can also use them as a platform for drug delivery and enter the space of theranostics, the combination of therapy and diagnostics. We've done a lot of work that has been widely appreciated by the scientific community in a number of peer-reviewed publications, and we have the key patents in this space. To enter into anything related to optical imaging with diamonds, you're gonna have to work with Vikanta. We have more than 20, we have about 20 patents that are in the range from provisional all the way through granted that have been filed broadly across the world in the key countries. And we group them into these four categories of families of patents. The overall market size is actually quite large because there are a number of applications that the diamonds can go into, ranging from a lot of R&D markets in microscopy and ex vivo diagnostic tools, and then into the in vivo applications. Our real true goals are in the clinical direction, Particularly, we are starting with melanoma imaging and doing the earliest detection of margins to reduce the cost of back and forthing that's currently being done in most procedures. From that demonstration and proof of concept, we'll then move into some of the more some of the other applications that can be used for diamonds as well. So we have the contrast agent. As a company, it's very clear what our path is. First, we worked on developing the contrast agent, the particles. Now we've moved into the stage where we're starting to develop the instrumentation, and then our third is to combine these together for the molecular diagnostic application. We raised money in order to do this strategically, and we're currently now launching our Series A and raising a $6 million round. And with that, we will then complete our instrumentation development, our first instrument that will be able to use the particles that we've already developed and have begun selling now in order for these applications. So we've started with a prototype, and I just spoke, sorry. Our team is it's just jumping around. Our team has a lot of qualifications academically and in industry, and we're very excited to have this opportunity to speak to you, so thank you very much.
Everyone, please thank Amika. Okay, next we have Greg King of Fiberline. Everyone, please give him a warm round of applause.
Good afternoon. So Fiberline is a spin-off of Stanford University, and we're focused on regenerative medicine applications to address large unmet medical needs by developing therapeutic medical devices based on scaffolding technology that we've developed. And it's a little bit analogous to 3D printing, how we make these structures and take that forward. It's a platform technology, so we decided to focus first on initial product and initial indication. But I wanted to give you, in this short time I have, a brief view of where we're going with this. The first product is called BioBridge, and it's a thread-like collagen scaffold made of highly purified collagen. And it looks somewhat unremarkable, because it looks a bit like dental floss or a suture, but it has a tremendous number of applications. Where we're going to take it initially is to treat secondary lymphedema, and I'll spend a couple minutes describing this opportunity going forward. I've seen the problem with formatting here, but the second place we're going to target this is going after peripheral artery disease, where there's a huge impact, about 200 million people worldwide having this disease and poor treatment options going forward. And we're taking it pretty far already with a preclinical study with one of our strategic partners. And then we're looking at nerve repair as an application area, which is a $1.8 billion market opportunity just in the US alone, and great needs to try to get away from using explants, harvesting from the patient's own bodies to do these repairs itself. And what we've seen through the collaboration we've done with Stanford and other groups is it's a great microenvironment for actually doing cell delivery and gene therapy. So we're working both on autologous cell therapies, iPS cell development with a group in Japan, and working with modified messenger RNA with CRISPR gene therapy with a grant we have at the DOD. So I won't spend any more time on those topics, but let's talk about secondary lymphedema. This is actually a very large chronic neglected disease in the world. And actually occurs from the earlier conversation a bit too about when cancer gets treated, often it causes this effect. It disrupts the lymphatic system when lymph nodes are removed and radiation occurs. And for some patients, they develop this chronic disease where the pooling of lymphatic fluid goes into the affected limb. So you see these larger limbs and elephantitis things occurring. It's a painful chronic disease, as I mentioned, and there's no cure for it. And because it compromises the immune system, which is what the lymphatic system is for, it causes a lot of other complications from infections and fibrosis and other problems too. The expected cost in the US for health burden per year is about $50,000. And there's about 15 million people worldwide that have this disease from cancer related. And another 120 million, which is a mind-boggling number, have it from a parasitic infection called filariasis, 40 million in India alone. So what we've done is we've developed an approach of taking the scaffold that I just described here in a little more detail, that we actually print by aligning nanofibrils of collagen, depositing it in a 1-inch wide membrane that's only 1 micron thick, so extremely thin layer, and have a way for it to get collapsed in the form of thread. So you see this kind of cross-section here. We have a large amount of surface area, and the fibrils are all aligned one direction. This has been optimized over 3 years of working with Stanford in preclinical studies to get the right response from endothelial cells to form new vessels. These physical cues encourage them to align and migrate and form these vessels going forward. So it's not a bypass, but it's a temporary scaffold these new vessels form along. We got 510K clearance for this product through the FDA for use as a surgical mesh. And they asked us to go get some more data in order to support the clinical data to support the use for lymphedema. So we did a small pilot study in the Dominican Republic, and now we're doing a multi-site study being led by Stanford University. It's already been started now with initial patients having surgeries. And essentially, we're doing this as an adjunct to a current surgical procedure that's used in part of breast reconstruction surgery. First surgeries have been done. We actually just received a $3 million grant from the National Cancer Institute to support this study and some other activities. So we're actually adding additional sites. We're talking Memorial Sloan Kettering. The University of Chicago is being additional sites for this. So this represents three of the world-leading centers that are working with lymphedema treatments going forward. So it's a very exciting opportunity. The market opportunity is significant. If we just look at chronic lymphedema by itself, the people that already have the disease, about 7 to 8 million of them are in the US and Europe. So just looking at US and Europe by itself, it's about a $12 billion market potential. We're going to target this by going after microsurgeons, plastic surgeons that are doing breast reconstruction surgery. Where it gets interesting, though, too, is to look at it as a preventative treatment. If we could actually put these scaffolds in during the treatment of cancer, we could prevent the disease from developing. That's just looking again, US and Europe, about 700,000 women get breast cancer treatments. That's about a $1 billion market opportunity for us on a yearly basis going forward. And with this group, we're going to focus on oncologists. So the product strategy is quite simple. We actually make these threads ourselves in our clean room operations in Union City. We package them in a five-pack, a sterile five-pack that's used to support the surgical procedures. Working worldwide with key opinion leaders in China, in Taiwan, in the EU, in Japan, and of course the US. We have a small team of 7 employees, but they're all multidisciplinary with advanced materials background to take this forward. And have a chief medical officer just joined us as an expert in this field. We have a good group of collaborators, and it's just a subset of those, a lot of them coming from Stanford, of course, where we come from. We have production in place in our clean room facility, just completing GMP operations and finishing up ISO certification. And we've completed all the product development, all the GMP work going forward. This next phase is actually going for a European approval, getting CE mark, which we're about to submit an application for the next 2 weeks, and scaling the production going after customer demand. 18 patents worldwide, another 13 pending. We've raised $3 million before this round. We're closing a $6.5 million round right now, $4.5 million already raised. We plan to raise another round in the next quarter, in the fourth quarter. That's all my time, so I appreciate it. We think we have a very exciting opportunity here for treating lymphedema. Oops, I'm sorry, I'm going ahead. And we have a great pipeline, sorry for the pictures. We have a great pipeline of product opportunities going forward. So thank you very much.